Hello student, welcome to the new month. Today is 1st and July, so you go to the new month, okay? Okay, so before we go to our new lesson, I want to review you about verb to be, or you can say to be, okay? So how many to be, everyone? 3, right? Am, is, and are. So what subject used with to be am? So I, right here. So I. So what subject you with to be? You, we, they. Oh, sorry. What to be used with you, we, they? So are. So how many subject that used with how many subject pronoun that used with is he, she, it. So always use with is, you with the, use with are, I use with am. But not only just subject pronoun can use with to be, am, is, are, but also have subject noun too, like the name of people, like Lisa, refer to personal pronoun she, so use with is. Megara and Lisa refer to personal pronoun they, so we use with are. Or you can say you and I. You and I mean a subject of pronoun you and I together refer to we, can be personal we, so we use with are too, okay? Okay, so I also want to correct your homework from yesterday. Yes, so on page 26 first. So for exercise 1 here, sing a song. So this one, I also send you audio already, so you listen already, okay? Now let's go to number 2, spot the differences. So there are 2 desks here. And then look at the object on the desk, excite. And then you have to spot on the differences. Spot on the differences, okay? Now look at here. We also saw the book here, the notebook here, the same. The ruler here, the same. But the difference is textbook here and also pencil case. And look under the desk here. So under the desk, 2 sides here are different. So here the difference is the textbook is under the desk and the pencil case is under the desk. So here dot, first dot, second dot, the fourth and the fifth. Okay. So here I draw this one and this one, this one and this one. How about you? You got the correct answer, everyone? Okay, great. Okay, now let's go to the next exercise. It's exercise on page 25. This one, listen again and circle the correct answers. Here are the correct answer. For number 1, is his teddy bear black? Yes. So yes, it is. Number 2, what is his name? His name is Dennis, okay? Number 3, what is his favorite color? His favorite color is yellow. Okay, A. What color is his ball? So his ball, the color of his ball is yellow and blue. So you all get the correct answer. Okay, now go to the next one here. So the last exercise is read and circle the answer. So what her name? So her name is Amanda. What color is her pencil? Her pencil is black. What color is her ruler? Her ruler is yellow. Okay. Okay, so now let's go to our lesson. Okay. Everyone, I want you to tell me, look at the picture on page 26 here. So I ask you the question, okay? And then you answer me, okay? Ask you about, where is the book, everyone? look at the picture and tell me. So the book is on the table. Where is the pencil? So the pencil is in the pencil case. Where is the ruler? The ruler is under the chair. Okay, so I ask you the question here. My purpose is today I'm gonna teach you about preposition in, on, and under. Okay, now let's go. Here. Okay, so today you're gonna learn grammar, preposition, on, in, under. Okay, so on, in, under here we call preposition. But the full thing is preposition of place. But I just write preposition on, in, and under. Okay, so now we go to the first one, preposition on. Okay, preposition on. I'm gonna show you on here. So like the book here is on the desk. So on, like this, on. Okay, I have two sentences that I got from this example in this picture. So I write down, the book is on the table. Okay, the book is on the table. Okay, and one more, I saw the pencil case is on the table too. I also write down, the pencil case is on the table. The pencil case is on the table. Okay, now let's go to the next one, is preposition in. Preposition in. Okay, so here I got one sentence from this picture and one I make it by myself. Okay, so where is the pencil, everyone? In this page 26, is the pencil is in the pencil case. The pencil is in the pencil case. And one more, I want to ask you, where is the clothes? So the clothes is always in the closet. So I make the clothes is in the closet. Okay, the clothes is in the closet. Okay, now let's go to the next one. Preposition under. Preposition under. So I also got the answer from here too. So I'm gonna ask you, where is the ruler? So where is the ruler? The ruler is under the chair, right? So I got the sentence is, the ruler is under the chair. The ruler is under the chair. Where is the chair? Here, you will see the chair is under the table. So I will say, the chair is under the table. The chair is under the table. Okay? Okay, so now you know already. So now we go to use here. Use. We use preposition on, in, under to show how an object or thing is positioned. Again, we use preposition on, in, under to show how an object or thing is positioned. You know the position mean? It means a place or located of a thing or object. Okay, like in this example. So the position of the book is on the table. The position of the pencil case is on the table too. The position of the ruler is under the chair. The position of the chair is under the table. It means that we want to know about the place of the object or thing is. Okay? Okay, so I got you three examples. that I make from this use. Okay, example, the whiteboard is on the wall. So you always saw the whiteboard is under the wall. The money is in the wallet. So all the money is in the wallet. Okay, the shoes is under the sofa. The shoes is under the sofa. Okay, so I want you to write down the lesson into your book. Okay, so today I also have one homework for you. Go to okay, everyone. So now let's go to homework. So I have one homework for you. So look at picture A here, the picture A here. Write yes it is or no it isn't. Okay, for example, the question they ask you that is the box under the tables. So look at the picture here, and then where is the box? You can see the box here. Is the box under the chair? The answer yes it is or no it isn't. When you see the picture, and then you will know the answer, you gonna say yes or no. Okay, but look at the picture here. Number two, is the crayon on the table? Number three, is the ruler in the box? Number four, is the kite on the table? So you just say the answer yes it is and no it isn't by choose only one answer to answer for each question. Okay, so go to Befriend Fun Book on page 17. Okay everyone, so that's all for today.